My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness.
How to have it in full measure. We thank you for it. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the precious Holy Ghost in Jesus Christ we pray. Amen.
In the month of February, this month when we celebrate love and Black History Month, we've been using for a theme, it's all about love. Last week we preached from the sermon, Which Way Do I Go? We looked at 1 Corinthians chapter number 13, we looked at chapter number 12, and we remembered the time that the early church was having, and how they were struggling with sanctification and division and all types of sin, and how they were even perplexed about how they were to behave within the body of Christ as it related to the gifts of the Spirit. And yet, Paul writes, and he tells them in chapter number 12, verse number 31, I show you a more excellent way. So the way to go, he decided, was, according to Paul, it was the way of love. He talks about the diversity of gifts, the manifestation of the gifts, the importance of all gifts. But when he opens up chapter number 13, he says, listen, I want you to know that it doesn't matter what you can do. If you do not have love, you're nothing. So love is the more excellent way. It's the way that the Lord wants us to go, not just today, but every day. Today I want to use as a subject for sermon number 2, do you love me or do you love me not? The way to go is the way of love. It is the more excellent way, but the question on the table today is, do you love me or do you love me not? Do you really know when somebody loves you? How do you know when you say I love you that you're actually walking in love and not just giving lip service? So easy for some folks to say I love you when it's hard for others, but even those who would break down and say it, do they really mean it? How do we know? That's what we're going to look at today. Do you love me or do you not? Or how is my love walk? We don't want you to examine anybody else's love walk, but let us examine our own love walk this morning. But also you will be able to determine if somebody really loves you or not. Look at verse number 4, if you will. Let me say here parenthetically that in verses 1 through 3, Paul makes it clear that it profits us nothing if we are not walking in love. In other words, you can't grow, you can't develop. There will be no increase. There's no profit without love. You can have all kinds of things, you can do all kinds of things, but without love, we are nothing. Look at verse number 4. When we look at verse number 4, you see that love is strong and humble. Paul talks about it this way. He said, a love suffers long. Is he suffering long with you? Are you suffering long with him? Do you have patience in your love walk? And he says that love is kind. It's long-suffering and kind. So kind is you are warm-hearted. You are considerate of others around you. You're not just focused on yourself. See, love is strong. It takes a strong person. It takes a strong love to be long-suffering, because folks will cut you off real fast today. Folks won't give you what Peter said. He said, Lord, should I forgive them 7 times? He said, no, 70 times 7. But folks won't give you but 1 chance. Don't know what we say. Fooling once is on me. Right? We won't give you but 2 chances. But the Bible is clear that love is strong. It's so strong that it doesn't fold. It's patient. And in that patience, it does not complain, because when you are complaining, you're not patient. You see, patience is a good expectation that sooner or later, God is going to make it happen for me. It's kind. It's considerate. But it's also humble. You see it right there in verse number 4. It does not envy. One writer says, love is satisfied with what it has. It ain't looking at somebody else's yard, not looking at somebody else's shoes, not looking at somebody else's ring. Love is satisfied with what God has provided. It does not envy what somebody else has. It's not vaunted up. It's not puffed up. It's not prideful. Love is not on display like a peacock. Love is strong, it's humble. I hear the Lord say, even now, if you humble yourself under my mighty hand, I'll lift you up in due season. Love is strong and humble. Do you love me? Or do you love me not? Verse number 5, look at it. It lets you know that love is under control. Somebody say under control. Love does not behave itself unseemingly. It's not under. It is not out of control. Love doesn't seek her own. Love is concerned about the welfare of somebody else. This is the one that I really like. It said, love is not easily provoked. Are you easily provoked? How many nerves do you have left? Or you always living on just your last nerve? Love is not easily provoked. Love thinketh no evil. In essence, love will give you the benefit of the doubt. Love doesn't think evil about others. Love will think the best about our fellow man. Love is under control. Aren't you glad that love is under control? Verse number 6 says that basically that love is righteous. Love won't rejoice in iniquity, but it will rejoice in the truth. The love is righteous. You see, the songs we grew up on got us messed up about what love really is. Somebody said, if loving you is wrong, I don't want to be right. Yeah, love is right. Love will do what's right. Love is all about righteousness. Somebody said, love will make you do right, and love will make you do wrong. That's a lie. Make you do wrong. Love will make you do right. Love is righteous. Love is the word of God. Love is obeying the word of God. But love will rejoice in the truth. Love doesn't rejoice in sin and iniquity. Love doesn't say, I'm sure he got what he deserved. Love say, God has a way for every man and woman. God can raise up anybody from any situation. But then I like verse number 7 because it begins to let us know that love conquers all. I want to encourage somebody today. Doesn't matter what you're going through. Doesn't matter what you're dealing with right now. I want you to know that if you turn to love, that love conquers all. Let folks do what they do. You just stay in love. Listen to what Paul said. He said, love bears all things. In other words, love can conquer anything. Love can overcome anything. Love is greater than anything that you're facing today. Love will cause you to believe all things, hope all things, and endure all things. Verse number 8 said, but love never fails. And Paul has to go back to the church and remind them, stop fighting over the gifts and stop thinking about I'm more holy than somebody else based on the gift that God gave them. He said love never fails, but whether there be prophecies, man, we need prophecy, but they should fail. And whether there be tongues is a great gift given by God, but the word says they shall cease. Without knowledge, we shall be destroyed, we perish. Or whether there be knowledge, it shall vanish away. We know in part, and we prophesy in part, but when that which is perfect has come, then that which is in part shall be done away. Don't you love verse number 11? When I was a child, I spake as a child, I understood as a child, I even thought as a child, but when I became a man, I began to walk in love. I put away childish things, envy, childish things, impatient, gotta have it right now, childish things, envy and want what somebody else had, childish things, a prideful childish thing, out of control, childish, easily provoked, childish, thinking evil, rejoicing in that which is wrong, all the childish things. When I became a man, when I became an adult, I put away childish things. Now I got to tell you this before I take the seed. It takes courage to love. How many of you know it takes courage to love? Don't you know that John 14 verse